I wish you all a very, very fine good morning. It was said, keynote address, keynote. I think the note is already with you as Justice Bhavar Singh put you in the historical context of human rights, where you can begin with somewhere and have all the details that how human rights idea has developed, how the idea expanded itself, how the context is already with you. But I am a teacher. I believe in one important thing, that is, whenever I go to class first time, I tell them that I have not come with a bowl of fried fish, which you will have. But I have come with a technique. I want to make you understand how to catch the fish and have the fish every day, so that you are yourselves able to find out the things. So the note is there. I want to give you the key. Regime emerging in this great nation, India, and then you become the torch bearers of human rights as the best in record in human rights. A nation may be so much good in history, and the existing and the contemporary world, the world demands one important thing, that how good your human rights record is. If your human rights record is good, then you are good. And if your human rights record is not good, whatever you may be possessing, it's not going to be appreciated there. Therefore, a big applause should come from the audience to the framer of this term, Human Rights Melodies and Remedies, Mr. Aman Sahani. I believe he has a vision. And that vision is so great that he wants to present his nation to the world that we are the torch bearers of human rights. And then he has selected for that a very, very important symbol also, that is Dr. Nelson Mandela. How many people in the country can think like that? And therefore, I think half of the battle of having the best record of human rights is already won. Because when you make a very, very good beginning, that means you are on the right track, and whatever your potentials are there, you can put them to task and attain the results. So, dear friends, if your idea is great, if your thought is great, if you possess the wealth of any kind,
this is a very big university.
Then I told them, how can you say it is big? They said, there are so many faculties in this university. I said, anything more? Another student said, there are so many courses offered in this university. Another came up and said, there is so much of land with this university. So many things. I said, you are all correct, but you are not saying the main important thing. What is that? I said, that was the idea of establishing the university. Because then you got the key. And where lies the key? The key lies somewhere where Justice Bhavar Singh was telling to you in history. And if you have no time to get into history, please get into yourself and then find out the key. So it is away, it is so near. Choice is yours, but you must have the idea, you must have the will to find it out. You will get it and you will do the things. So here I will point out that in earlier times when there used to be tribes, when there used to be later on kingdoms, when later on there used to be having some different other kinds of polities, and then ultimately it resulted into the modern state. And in all these periods of history, there had been human miseries, and human being has suffered at the hands of another human being. And one who is not having power suffers at the hand of another person who is in power. One who is in an exploiting position enjoys it, and then one who is not in an exploiting position does not, he suffers and he is under misery. And then the thing is that when human being is a human being, he deserves respect as a human being. Aadmiyat, ehtiram-e aadmiyat. And then it says, beware, bakhabar, beware, beware of the status of the human being. So you have understood that human rights are a handle in your hand. You can restrict the state power. Don't do it. It goes against the human rights. You are negligent, you are not doing it, and therefore do it, because that's for human rights. If there are starvations taking place in this country, if there are suicides taking place in this country, if there are underprivileged people and they are suffering in this country, you can move the court of law and tell to the government, come forward and do this action and don't do this action because of human rights. And I think that good group of human rights activists will definitely come out of this Delhi Metropolitan Education. So you have to imbibe that spirit of human rights, then come forward and be active and see wherever the violation of human rights takes place, either by the overaction of the authorities or by the underaction of the authorities. In both ways, you have to come forward and you have to agitate them, and then you have to become a true representative of Mandela or Lord Ram or in Lord Buddha and like that.